Hello, hello everyone. It's me, Arden Lee, and I'm back today with another video. I am going to be starting a video series where I've asked some of the members of my free Facebook group called The Repatterning Parlor to tell me about some of the issues in their lives that they're struggling with so I can make some videos that are helpful to them. So this is the first in that series. And this video is about how to stop seeking so much romantic approval from people outside yourself, whether those people are actual people in your life or whether it's just, you know, the imaginary ideal lover or, you know, the idea of men or of women in general, you know, that we're looking to change ourselves, you know, to compromise our authenticity in order to gain the approval of those people. So that's going to be our first topic today. And of course, before I get into that, if you're not already familiar with me and my work, my name is Arden Lee. I am the creator of The Repatterning Project, which is an 8-week course where we hack our beliefs and we pop the hoods and see what's going on with all our patterns and our habits. And we make our choices more and more conscious so we can make our decisions and make our choices based on what's going to bring us the most happiness and fulfillment. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, go ahead and check out the description box where I have a link to a free PDF about the course, and you can go ahead and download that free PDF guide to see what we're all about. And I also have a link to the free Facebook group that I just mentioned. As I said, we are called The Repatterning Parlor. And in this series of videos, I'm making these videos to address the specific issues that that the members of my group are have said that they are dealing with in their own lives. So if that sounds like something that's fun to you, if you want to come together and you want to receive that kind of support, go ahead and click on that link, answer the three questions that will pop up before you are admitted for approval. And hopefully I will see you there. Do introduce yourself if that's the route that you go. I love knowing where people have found about me. So, all right, let's get into this topic first off. So this person has asked a question. They said that they're struggling with looking for approval outside of themselves to the point where they feel like it's causing them some anxiety. In my understanding, it's causing them that they're really valuing the approval of other people over the freedom of their own self-expression, over their own well-being, over their own self-worth, that they're basing their self-worth, their opinion of themselves on the approval that they feel that they're either getting or not getting from other people. And I want to emphasize that I think that problem can, like I said, that can be about specific people in general. You know, that can be about what we sense other people's opinions of us are, or it can just be this sort of general, this idea of just like, am I attractive to the opposite sex? You know, do I fit the mold of what's considered attractive in society? And I know a lot about this struggle for approval, considering that I spent my 20s as a dating coach, as a pickup artist, and I wrote a book called The New Rules of Attraction, which was essentially a manual for women who were looking to empower themselves in becoming more attractive to their specific demographic. And I look back at that and I do believe that that making that sort of attractiveness of that sort of general attractiveness that we look at in society that can so often feel so inaccessible to us if we don't feel we're attractive, I took that and I basically tried to make it accessible to everyone. It's like, if you want to walk into the room and be the hot girl who's turning everyone's head, like, I got you. Like, there's a way that you can do that. You can break it down into a simple formula. So I actually think it was kind of revolutionary and kind of like, in a weird way, it was kind of very socialist, right? It was kind of like taking this thing that was supposed to be reserved for, you know, for just the elite attractive, you know, people in the world and making it accessible to everyone. So, but the shadow side of that is that if we spend too much time and too much energy conforming to what other people expect of us, or what we even feel other people expect to us, what we believe other people are going to find attractive, we get to this point where we end up really sacrificing our authenticity and our our real true expression of who we are. You know, we end up editing ourselves down, and I ended up taking that path so far. Even after the book was out, I lived that path so hard that when I finally decided to stop, when I finally decided to really go inward and figure out what I could do to get to really, like, I guess, you know, I was still looking to solve my relationships. But what was happening to me was I had edited myself down so hard that there was so much of myself that I wasn't expressing. And naturally, that led to a lot of toxic relationships, because when you when you're editing yourself down because you're afraid of being unattractive or you're afraid of being inconvenient to people, what ends up happening is you end up saying, like, oh, it's fine, I have no needs, I just want to be whatever you want me to be. And when you believe that, when you're willing to pretend that you have no needs, you end up attracting people who agree with you. So, and that never leads to a positive relationship situation. So what I've learned since then, and what I want to make this video about, is essentially the idea that I want to be able to convey to you that the more you can tap into your own true authentic expression, the more you really get to the core of who you are, the more likely you're going to be to attract a partner who's actually right for you. So think about it this way. If you're trying to appeal to everyone out there, if you're trying to get this sort of vague approval from the opposite sex, if you want to be appealing to the masses, essentially, what's going to happen is that you're going to get a whole bunch of people who are attracted to you who are not right for you. I'm going to say that again. If you're trying to appeal to everyone out there, you might get a whole bunch of people who are attracted to you who are absolutely not right for you. And that's not actually a healthy situation. Even though we think that having more options is better, it's not necessarily better if they're not actually seeing us for who we are. It's kind of like taking, I was speaking to a client once who had this sort of problem as well with wanting to be a people pleaser so that she could be found more attractive by people in the world. And I essentially said, what you're doing when you do that is, like, if finding the person who's really right for you and really vibes with you is like solving a Where's Waldo puzzle, you're taking your Where's Waldo that used to be on a spread of 2 pages in a book, and you're blowing it up on the side of a 10-story building, like a mural. And now you're trying to find that person among all these people, right? and that doesn't really work out for us very well. I think it's really interesting that when I was in that phase of my life where I was concentrating so hard on doing all of the things that would make me seem attractive across the board, you know, for example, like things that felt like it was almost inarguably, like they were almost like inarguably attractive qualities, right? I went into sexuality education. I wanted to look like I was, you know, sexually empowered, and that I was also, you know, able and capable of embodying almost any fantasy, right? And that was, you know, also because I had spent time as a pro dom and as a BDSM educator, and I was certainly familiar with handling any kind of fantasy as well. And I was like, oh, that's a great selling point as a lover, right? I can just be anything that you want me to be. And I also worked at establishing myself a sort of little mini career as a lingerie model. I modeled for a couple of indie brands. I was like, that's definitely attractive, right? You know, and so I was doing all these things that were very generically attractive, and I ended up getting, like, some really creepy fan mail, you know, for lack of a better word. I would get men who wrote to me who were convinced that I was their ultimate fantasy come true. You know, even on my dating profiles, you know, when I would describe myself, when I would describe what I did, I sometimes got messages on, you know, OkCupid and things like that, where guys were like, are you, like, literally there were a couple of people who were like, is this a real profile? Like, are you real? Or are you just like, yes, I'm a real person. And, you know, I can see where that would sort of be a compliment, but it was really lonely. It was super lonely. And I would get these emails sometimes from guys who were just convinced that I was their dream woman. And I'm like, you don't know me. Like, you've never met me. And I would get really angry about it at the time. I'd be like, look at you projecting all of this on me. But I look back at that now and I'm like, well, you know, I was trying so hard to be attractive to everybody, you know, to like everybody, but like the most, I don't know, I guess, you know, I wouldn't have been attractive to someone who was, you know, prude or not, you know, not in touch with their sexuality or whatever, since I was very outspoken about sexuality, about seduction, and about, you know, embodying our fantasies. But for most people, and even the people sometimes who were prudes, who you would think would not be, you know, have been attracted to me or whatever, you know, their repressed id would be attracted to me, and they'd want me, but then they'd also be ashamed of me, and that would cause conflict. You know, I even got into some relationships that were like that, you know, where someone may have felt that attraction to me, but they were so conflicted about it that, you know, that they kept me a secret, or they, you know, they felt that shame. And so they would, you know, leave and come back and leave and come back. And it was just torture. So trust me, just take it from someone who like, you know, who actually like remarkably succeeded at the wrong thing, you know, like I, you know, it was pretty remarkable that I was actually able to do that, to take on, you know, to find this narrow window of what is considered attractive to, you know, the sort of patriarchal male gaze, you know, because I'm a woman. You know, I'm a, you know, a woman who mostly dates men, not exclusively, but mostly, that's what I was aiming for. And it was like, okay, you know, you want to be sexual, but not too sexual. You want to be pretty, you want to be beautiful, but you still somehow want to look natural. You want to be, you know, this but not that, and that but not, you know, whatever. And it's pretty amazing how well I actually sort of worked that balance. You know, like, you want to be intelligent but not so intelligent as to be threatening or whatever. Like, you want to, you know, you want everything, you know, everything goes toward appealing to this fantasy. And it's pretty remarkable that I guess that I proved to myself that I was capable of that at the time. But it was bad. Like, it was lonely, you know, it was not fun. So I hope that helps to sort of make you understand that the thing that you're trying to do when you seek for this sort of mass approval, this sort of, you know, nebulous, ethereal approval of just the opposite sex in general, is you end up, if you're trying to attract everyone, then it actually becomes more and more difficult to find a satisfying relationship, because what you really want is someone who sees you for who you are. And honestly, the weirder I have allowed myself to be in the past couple of years, and I mean, I think it's pretty clear that I'm pretty, I don't know, I'm pretty, you know, I don't know, unique, you know, in the things that interest me, and in the way that my brain works or whatever, the things that I'm passionate about. And the more that I've allowed myself to do that, ironically enough, the more I've actually felt accepted, the more I've actually felt approval, because the people who really vibe with me, who really see me, give me, you know, that sense of belonging, you know, that I was craving, that sense of like, oh wow, yeah, I see you, I understand you, and I like you for who you are. And that's really the thing that you want to do. So the more you can tap into that unique, authentic expression, like, you know, there's something that my business coach tells me, and he's like, Arden, you want to write a lot of emails on your email list because you want to lose subscribers. If people are just kind of, you know, hanging around, you know, getting an email from you like once or twice a month or whatever, you know, it doesn't take a lot for them to, you know, to stay on your list or whatever. But if you're sending a lot of emails, then you're gonna narrow down to the people who actually really want your content. And that's what you want your email list to be. You don't want a whole bunch of subscribers who are never actually going to engage with you. You want those people who want you in their inbox every day. And so I'm gonna have you apply that to your dating life too. Like, you want those people who want you, like who really want you and who wanna be there with you. So the more you can express yourself authentically, ironically enough, the more you're actually going to find that real sense of approval. I almost don't want to use that word, but really it's that sense of belonging. You know, you're going to find those people who really vibe with you for real, and it's going to be so much more satisfying than if you just, you know, sort of have this sort of mass market appeal where everyone is projecting their shit on you, but no one really ever sees you or understands you. So I hope that was helpful, and stay tuned for more videos in this series. And thank you for listening. I'll see you in the next video.